Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dr. Yang. I'm from Changhua Christian Hospital. I'm a cardiologist. This time, my topic will focus on the update of the Dyslipidemia guideline in Taiwan. We know ASCVD. ASCVD means atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease. It's caused by the hyperlipidemia, the lipid deposit in the vessel wall, induce the inflammation. It makes the fatty streak and the fibrofatty plaque formation. If the plaque rupture, the core outside the plaque and make the blood flow decrease. So maybe the patient suffer from the myocardial infarction this time. So the endothelial play the very important role in the atherosclerosis. This figure shows the blue line means the genetic hyperlipidemia. If we can decrease the endothelial in genetic patient, we can decrease the risk of CHD. The gray line is a prospective cohort study. The same result is a genetic study. We can see the LDL decrease and the CHD risk decrease. The same in the randomized control study. The red line decreases the LDL and the risk of CHD decrease. Which lipid is the most important? According to the ESC guideline, the LDL is the most important. We can use it for the primary analysis, and it is a cheat target. HDL is not recommended as a target for treatment because the lipid is a better guide in our human body. So if we can control the bad lipid, the outcome will improve. So we see the 27 randomized control study. We use the meta-analysis to see the outcome. If we lowering the LDL, use the statin therapy. Decrease the LDL 1 millimole per liter. We will decrease the cardiovascular risk 25%. If we trace the lipid control history, we can see the Dr. Ido, he find the HMG CoA reductase, and then we use this one, HMG CoA reductase, to control the hyperlipidemia. So the LOVA study is the first US FDA study. During the 30 years, lots of studies approved by the FDA. And recently, the PCSK9 inhibitor and the ezetimibe was used for the second line or third line for the control lipid. How about the long-term result of a statin? The first study is all-cause trial. Result is 5 years follow-up. 2007. There is an article reveal the 15 years follow-up. 2016, there is one article. It is related to the 20 years follow-up. All of the results is good. If you use a statin, you can decrease the cardiovascular risk. Lots of statin was available on the market, just like the atorvastatin, rosuvastatin, or the lovastatin, rosuvastatin, and this is a meta-analysis web. So lots of statin was approved for increase the cardiovascular disease. So the ESC guideline said if the patient with the hyperlipidemia, you can use the statin first. if you not achieve the target, you can use the ezetimibe. And if you use the statin plus the ezetimibe, the LDL did not achieve the target, you can use a PCSK9 monoclonal antibody therapy. So I reviewed some guidelines. All the guidelines say we have to control the LDL first, not HDL. And if the patient without cardiovascular disease, the range may be higher than the patient with the cardiovascular disease. So if the patient without the cardiovascular disease, in the AHA, ADA, ESC, or the Japan guideline, or the Canada guideline, the LDL upper limit, they hope that we can control the LDL less than 100. But if the patient with the cardiovascular disease, maybe we can control LDL less than 70. If we cannot achieve the 70, we can alternative goal. Alternative goal means you can compare with the baseline. If you can achieve the 30 to 40% reduction, it can get the same outcome. About the Taiwan guideline for lipid control, the guideline published in 2017, it focuses on high-risk patients. What is a high-risk patient? The first is atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease. We call it ASCVD. Just like the acute coronary syndrome, it's including the unstable angina, non-STEMI and the STEMI. Or the coronary artery disease, or peripheral artery disease, the ischemic stroke. Diabetes, the risk is similar to ASCVD. And the CKD is included in the high-risk patient. The last one is familial hyperlipidemia. So how to use the medication to control the lipid? Statin is the first line. So we can use the lovastatin, pravastatin, simvastatin, or fluvastatin, anyone. Or atorvastatin, rosuvastatin. It's okay, because the statin can reduce the LDL. And we can try to use the ezetimibe if we not achieve the target. After these two medicines, we can consider to use the PCSK9 inhibitor. So the lipid lowering drug, just like the statin, or a cholesterol absorption inhibitor, or PCSK9 inhibitor. Other medicine, just like the nicotinic acid, or fibric acid, or omega-3 fatty acid. But these three, just like the statin, or ezetimibe, or PCSK9 inhibitor, is the most major medicine to control the lipid. So the guideline said statins are the first line therapy. We have to use the moderate or high intensity statin because this guideline is focused on high risk patient. So we have to use the moderate or high intensity statin because if we want to get the clinical outcome benefit, we have to use the statin just like the clinical trial. So if you want to choose the statin, we can try to use atorvastatin 40 to 80 milligram or rosuvastatin 20 to 40 milligram. This was separate to the high intensity statin because it can reduce the LDL 50%. The moderate intensity statin, just like the atorvastatin, the dose is lower, maybe from the 10 to 20 milligram. And the rosuvastatin from the 5 to 10 milligram. So what is our target? These guidelines, they classify the patient to different group. The HS and the diabetes, according to the improved study, the target is less than 55 milligram per deciliter. In stable CAD, the target is 70 milligram per deciliter. And in peripheral artery disease, we can control the LDL less than 100 milligram per deciliter. But if the peripheral artery disease and the coronary artery disease, the patient suffer from these two diseases, the LDL should be lower, less than 70 milligram per deciliter. Of course, we can control the lipid profile. There are secondary targets for ACS stable CAD or CAD with TG more than 200 milligram per deciliter. We can try to control the non-HDL cholesterol less than 100 milligram per deciliter. So my conclusion is, the hyperlipidemia is a risk factor of ASCVD, and the treatment is very important. Statin is the first-line therapy for lipid control. Ezetimibe is the second-line medicine for the lipid control. And if you use the statin and the ezetimibe, but the LDL is not achieved the target, we can consider to use the PCSK9 inhibitor for a third-line medication, but it's very expensive. So in Taiwan, the patient use PCSK9 inhibitor is not so common. The different LDL target for different patient type, just like the table, I showed the table previous. Thank you for your attention.